Hello, my name is Madeline Lawyer. I'm a speech language pathologist in private practice in Northern Virginia. And today I'm going to be telling you about Stemple vocal function exercises. These exercises are meant to help strengthen and rebalance the subsystems for speech, including the respiratory subsystem, which is our air that we should be using to drive phonation, using diaphragmatic breathing and engaging this muscle here. Our phonatory subsystem, which is our voice box. And last, our oral and nasal resonance, which we use to shape our speech. So follow along for some exercises and more information. When we think about Stemple vocal function exercises, we can kind of consider them like physical therapy for our vocal folds. There are 13 muscles that are responsible for turning on our voice. And so these muscles, if they become weak, or if we have an imbalance in those subsystems, they might require some attention through physical exercise. There's four parts to these exercises, and the first part is the warm-up. For the warm-up, you're going to do the warm-up exercise on a hypernasal E with the focus on your soft palate. There should be no excess laryngeal tension, although you also do not want to be breathy when you complete this first exercise. Be sure to have upright posture, relaxed shoulders, and engage your diaphragm with a big, full breath to drive your phonation. This warm-up exercise should be done for as long as you can possibly hold it out. If you produce a very quiet S sound and time yourself, that's a good goal for your lung capacity to know whenever you are completed with the exercises and your systems are rebalanced, how long you should be able to phonate. To test this, you can get a timer and produce an S like this. This first exercise should be produced on F above middle C for women and F below middle C for men. You can download a free piano app or a pitch pipe app to a smartphone that works really well for pitch matching. The research shows that you don't have to be able to produce the exact match note, you just have to be able to come close. I'm going to go ahead and demonstrate this first warm-up exercise for you. As a caveat, we want to make sure that we do not start with a hard onset called a glottal stop that would sound like this. You want to make sure that you're going into it with intention. However, you don't want that hard glottal stop, and you also don't want to have a breathy start, or you're not going to benefit from the exercises. This should not sound like singing. The literature actually even describes it as a nasty nasal sound. So if it sounds nasally, then you are doing it correctly. The next exercise is a stretching exercise. We are literally stretching out our vocal cords to work out that cricothyroid muscle. Whenever we do this, we want to have our throat wide open and our lips closed, but barely touching. You should be able to feel vibrations in your lips or your teeth or even your nose sometimes. This lets us know that you are using what's called a semi-occluded vocal tract for this exercise. This means that your vocal cords are coming together just enough to touch without any type of vocal press, yet no breathiness. So for exercise number two, you're going to start on the word nole, facilitating that big open throat with those lips just barely apart. So it's going to sound like this, and you're going to glide from your lowest note up to your highest note. No. Again, you should feel those vibrations in the front of your mouth. For exercise number two, it's normal if you're doing these exercises to have pitch breaks. It's probably part of the reason why you're doing these exercises because you don't have proper balance of your subsystem, or you have something like a vocal cord nodule that might cause pitch breaks in your glide. Persist through the exercises despite the pitch breaks, and hopefully at the end of your exercise program, you'll see that you don't have pitch breaks and your range has improved. This next exercise is the contracting exercise. It's meant to work the thyroarytenoid muscle, which is responsible for vocal cord contraction. When we contract our vocal cords shorten, they thicken, and their vibration becomes greater. Similar to the last exercise, you want to start at a comfortably high note, but not the highest note, because you want to make sure that you have adequate range. When you do reach the lower range that you're going for, you want to make sure that you're not engaging in a voice that is too deep. Pitch breaks, again, are okay. However, you don't want glottal fry, which would sound something like, when you reach down low to a note that is uncomfortably low. So the exercise is going to sound like this, and it's going to be conducted again on the word knoll. No. Again, big open throat and lips just barely touching so you can feel the vibrations. The last exercise is a power adductory exercise. It's responsible for strengthening those muscles that pull your vocal cords together. You're going to do this across five musical notes, starting with middle C for women and one C below that for men. You want to sustain it as long as you can, and you're going to produce this one on old without the D. Again, you want to focus on big open throat and use your diaphragmatic breathing. So I'm going to demonstrate the power adduction exercise for you now. I've got my piano app here to pitch match. Again, just like the other exercise with matching F, you do not have to perfectly match each note. You just have to come close in order to benefit. Oh. You're going to hold that out for as long as you can and then move up to the next note. Oh. Oh. You'll continue this across the five notes.